Meow. purpose have you awoken Ln'eta the Starspawn and brought about the end of reality? To be the first human to be destroyed, yes? So that you are spared from the cataclysm I shall wreak upon all life.
What? Don't say it again, creep! And how are you looking directly at me without being driven mad? Send me back. I'll do it next time. Maybe when the stars realign in 1,000 years or so. Exactly. Where'd you get that book? Moo. Always trying to set me up with someone. It's not a Necronomicon. What Necronomicon is bright pink, silly? It's a survival guide. For dating me. Mm-hmm. It's full of rituals that I like. Offerings, spells, and how to protect your sanity while performing them. I am a cosmic entity beyond comprehension. So no amount of contact with me is safe for a human. Your mind could snap like a reed at any moment, actually. Oh, don't make that face. I can make it worth your while, if you understand what I'm getting at. But if you chicken out or go insane, I'll end reality right then and there. You knew what you were getting into when you woke me up, right, darling? Excellent! Let's begin the date then. Why don't you start with the Invoke the Depths ritual? you read the spell's name. Our connection is stronger now. The closer you get to where my true form lies dreaming, the stronger my influence on you in this world. Just focus on following the book perfectly. You're good to start doing these rituals on your own, right? I'm just feeling a little icky from the summoning, so I wanted to use your shower. Do you mind? Thanks. No peeking. I mean it. Don't peek. Mm-hmm. You're sure you won't? All right, I'll be back in a jiffy. I love foggy, rainy days by the sea. It's like my favorite weather on the surface world. I didn't know you have a house on the water! There's something just so romantic about standing on a balcony during a storm. What's wrong, darling? Getting chilly? We can go inside if you like, but it's not like it's any safer in there. After all, the next page in the book has an unspeakable horror on it. You'll see what I mean. That's why it's an unspeakable horror. Unspeakable, get it? As in, cannot be spoken. At least not by humans. Of course I can. I can pronounce anything. Anything. Worcestershire sauce? point.
How do you do? I hope it wasn't too forward of me to call upon you in your own private department. If I may be so bold, I have something special to give you. May I come in? It's not the kind of present I can give you out in the open. I can't go out after dark. Why can't we just go inside? I really want to give you your present now.
Darling, what's taking so long? I miss you.
Huh? Who is that? You have company over? Inside your apartment?
What's going on, darling?
Let me in! Now!
Want me to make them go away?
nothing? Is that the truth?
Did I scare you, darling?
Good. I know what page you were on.
And if I see you trying to cast that spell about nothing, you won't get past the second word.
Smells delicious, darling. All it needs is a little something and it'll be perfect. I'm going to take a short walk outside while you finish. See you in a few, love.
Thank you.
can tell by the look on your face. You caught a glimpse of the real world now that I'm waking up. Guess you aren't as sane as you thought, huh, darling? Oh, sweetie, don't worry about reality. It doesn't have anything to do with you anymore. Though, I should tell you, everything you saw and heard, it's still there. What you saw coming through your window is still coming through. Very soon, it'll be impossible to deny its presence, and even escaping reality won't protect you. If you like, I could move you to the front of the line and you painlessly myself, as thanks for waking me up. You wouldn't hear their screams anymore, or feel that chill up your spine where that tentacle is already touching. Or maybe you'd prefer to be saved for last. Have the whole doomed world all for yourself for a while. Though the things you'd see if you lingered. Being destroyed first or last? Which would you prefer, my darling? I wish you could make offerings like this forever! Well, my devoted darling, there is only one last spell to perform, pledging yourself to me! Take heart. Your pledge of devotion will be the last act of humanity for all of time. The final words ever spoken by humankind will come from your fairy mouth and echo into oblivion. The privilege is yours alone. I may be inexperienced with human emotions, but even I know that saying goodbye to your world can be painful. Take all the time you need to make peace with the end. I'm going to take a short nap, but could you hit the lights for me, darling? I'm afraid it's time for the dream and our date to end.
That look on your face. Darling, I had a wonderful date with you. And that's because of you. So why destroy me? And all of reality? Why not just stay here with me? That's what you're thinking, right? Oh, my sweet, mortal darling. I'm not doing this out of malice. You've had good dreams before, right? Well, when you woke up, you destroyed those dream worlds and everything in them. Did you wake up because you hated those dreams? No. It just couldn't be helped that you'd wake up eventually. I love humans, and I'll miss you sorely. Please let your last thoughts be about that. Forgot about my promise to you. Pucker up, my darling. You've earned it.